Hello, Herman here with a new video in the ClearPass workshop series where we build a ClearPass deployment from scratch and integrate with wired, wireless, Active Directory and much more. In the last videos, we built a cluster, activated the licenses, so we should be all good. Next step is to connect our instant AP to the ClearPass deployment and connect the first client, and we will be using EPTLS. So there will be some certificate stuff in here as well. So here's my ClearPass, and let's first have a look at our instant AP. So I prepared an instant AP. And you probably have seen this before. Otherwise, there are other videos on how to operate instant APs. Few things that I would advise here under system. We can put a virtual controller IP and we can enable the dynamic radius proxy. What this will do is, regardless of the IP address that the AP gets through DHCP, it will always be reachable on this IP address 10.2 as well. What it will do, if there is a radius request to the ClearPass server for the authentication, at that point, the request will be sent from this IP address as well. So from the ClearPass, where we will need to configure our radius client, we can then use this specific network. Let's very quickly create our SSID. So make this Airheads-Corp. We make it wireless. Primary use will be employee. For now, let's keep the defaults. Now here we can choose the security level for enterprise. So we'll leave it on WPA2 enterprise for now. Then here we can add the new authentication server. So that will be the ClearPass server. And I create the virtual IP here, the virtual IP that is primary on the publisher. Radius using a shared key, so I type that shared key. I will fill that later on in the ClearPass server as well. And for later on, let's enable dynamic authorization. Not needed now, but we'll need it at one point. So we'll leave it like this for the default. Then we can as well take the subscriber in here. Again, this is the virtual IP that's available on the subscriber. Shared key, that will be the same shared key because it's a cluster and the network access devices are shared across the cluster. And as well, turn on dynamic authorization here. Then it's good to have accounting enabled. Use the authentication server and the accounting interval. Let's set it to 3 minutes for now. We can enable OKC. 11R, K, and V, just as a best practice. For now, we do nothing with role-based access. We'll do that in a later lab, so let's first get everything working. So we leave it unrestricted here. And we are finished. There is our Airheads-Corp SSID. Now let's have a look from a client. Let's see if we can see the SSID. Not yet. There it is. So let's try to click on it. Let's see what happens. I don't think it will work at the moment. So no, it doesn't work. Now let's have a look at our ClearPass server because troubleshooting is also part of the workshop. So let's have a quick look. So this is our ClearPass policy manager. Then here, first of all, we check access tracker. So access tracker, we do not see anything in the access tracker. If there's nothing in the access tracker, we go to the event viewer. And in the event viewer, we see a lot of authentication errors here. So let's have a look at it. We do see a radius authentication attempt from an unknown network access device, any of these network access devices, and this is the IP. So this is my instant IP. This means my instant IP was reaching out to the ClearPass server, but it didn't work. So let's fix that. We go here to the network devices, and we create a new network device here. We can use a subnet, or we can just use a single IP. Let's for now take the single IP. So the IP address is the IP address that we saw coming in. Always good to put descriptions to your configuration, because later on it will help you to understand what you actually did. Here I put in the same radius shared secret that I put in the instant AP. And the vendor name is Aruba, of course, and the radius dynamic authorization is enabled. So let's try again what happens if we connect. So again, now let's have a look in the access tracker. Still nothing. Maybe let's have a look if it's on the other node. Ah, there we go. It landed on the subscriber. Probably because the first IP address was not responding before and we had a backup. So it will fill over to another. So here from edit, you can select the server. So now I'm checking on the subscriber as well. So if you don't see any requests, it could be that you're looking on the wrong server. So let's have a look at what's the issue right here. So we do see an alert. We do see service categorization is failed. And that means we need to create a service for ClearPass. Now, next step is to create a service for ClearPass. Let's go here. Under services, we see there are a few services. Services are evaluated from the top to the bottom. And there is a first match on the service, and then it will go into that. So let's add a new one. We are using an 802.1x wireless for here. And then I typically try to start with some identifiers. So let's take WS for the workshop. Then we know that these servers are all belonging to the same deployment. And also these are not standard or factory default policies. We can see there are service identifiers. So this is evaluated when the service is checked. So from the top to the bottom, it will check for the request if it's an port type wireless, and if it's a service type this, then it will go into this specific service. Next, we have the authentication methods, and I mentioned we shouldn't be using the epip, so let's remove that. Let's remove the epfast. We will go full eptls, and for now, let's take the standard eptls without the common name check. We'll fix that later on. So next is that we need to enable the authentication source. The certificates that I have are issued by the Active Directory certificate service. We need to check the identity of the certificates to the AD so we can fetch other information like group membership of the user and other information about that user. So let's here add a new authentication source. So the type is Active Directory. Go to the next. Here we can put the host name of the primary domain controller. So in my lab, I only have one here. If you want to add backups, if you press add backup, you get another thing here. So we can remove it again. Now we need to put in the bindDN, and the bindDN can be any username. I would advise you to take a service account for that. For now, let's take just to show you that it's any username. I can put in here the password for that user. And now we can check if it works by pressing here the search basedn. There we go. So we can click on here, then we can see that we can browse the Active Directory. Again, as mentioned, don't take normal user accounts here that have password expiration. Use a service account that will not have any expiring passwords. So let's leave this. Now we can add that one. Let's go to the next step. Role mapping, we'll come to that later. So we'll skip it for now. Enforcement, we'll come to that later as well. So for now, we take the sample allow access policy. So it will just allow access if this authentication is successful. So let's try to connect again with my client. So still there is no connection. Let's have a look in the access tracker again. And we can see the services now match, so that's good. It's trying to do eptls. We have our authentication source correctly, but there's still an issue. And if there is an issue, you have the alerts tab here. And what you can see here is there is a fatal alert by the client. So the client thinks there's something wrong and it says unknown CA. And that's correct because we didn't put any certificates on our ClearPass server. In the next video, we will cover the installation and the request of the radio CA. And hopefully in that video at the end, we can connect to our wireless network and have authentication against ClearPass. Hope you like this video. Please subscribe to the channel. Put your comments under the video if you have any questions. And don't forget to press the like button as well. Thanks a lot for watching and see you next time.